Hello student, welcome to the one more session of this video. In this video you are going to learn the instruction set, that is load and store instruction. In my previous video I have explained data transfer instructions. So in this video we will see load and store instructions. Now before moving to load and store instruction, we know ARM7 operates 90% of the time ARM7 operates in register only. Only two instructions that will work between register and memory, that will work on the memory, is load and store. Load is to load the data from memory to the register of the processor. Store is to store the data from the register to the memory. So here we have a classification of instruction. We'll see one by one what and all instructions are there in load and store. So first one is, let me write here, the first one is LDR load register R0 comma bracket R1. Now what is the meaning of this one? LDR means load register. So your register R0 will get the data. Register R0 will get the data by the location pointed by this register. So anything in the bracket indicate address. So register R0 will get the data by the location or from the location pointed by this register. This is the example for indirect addressing mode. So LDR R0 R1. So here R0 will get 32 bit data. Please remember 32 bit data are stored in 4 location. Each location stores only 8 bits of data. So 4 location it will get 32 bit data, and 32 bit data are stored in R0. Now the second instruction. Second instruction is we have LDRB. And one more instruction is there, LDRH R0 comma R1. Similarly here also R0 comma R1. Actually, I said, like in my previous video, I told the data can be, or data may be 8 bit, 16 bit or 32 bit. It is not necessary that all the data what we load from memory should be 32 bit. It can be 8 bit. So 8 bit data is called as a byte. 8 bit data is called as a byte. Or it can be 16 bit. 16 bit data in the case of ARM7 is called as half old. In the case of ARM is called as half old. Based on the processing capability of the ARM, it is called as half old. And 32 bit data is called as a old. With respect to ARM, it is called as old. Now, suppose if the data is 8 bit, then we have instruction, that is LDRB load byte. It will load 8 bit of data from the memory location pointed by this register to R0. Or we have load register half old. It will load 16 bit of data from the memory location pointed by R1. So 16 bit data is loaded into the R0, or 8 bit data is loaded into the R0. Now, suppose the data is 25. The data is 25. Now then the R0 is contains 0000025. R0 contains 0000025. So now this works, both works for unsigned number. In case of unsigned number, all the succeeding positions are all the leading positions are filled by zeros. But in case of signed numbers, all these positions are filled by either 0 or 1 based on the sign bit, or MSB. Based on the MSB, all these positions are filled by zeros or 1s. So for that we have separate set of instruction, that is LDRB load byte, LDR SB load signed byte or load register signed afterward R0, R1 and here also R0, R1. So it will get the data from the memory location pointed by R1, but the rest of the positions are filled by 1 or 0 based on the MSB. In my previous video in the addressing mode I told signed extension of the data will take place. I have explained this one in architecture of ARM model. So this is the instruction. Similarly, we have other set of instruction, that is STR. So let me write here STR instructions. So STR R0 comma R1. The meaning of this one is it will load the content of register R0 to the location pointed by R1. So here 32 bit of data are stored from R0 to the 4 locations in the memory. So similarly, we have one more instruction STRB and STRH. STRB stands for byte, STRH stands for afterward. It will store a byte of data to the location pointed by R1. It will store 16 bit of data from R0 to the location pointed by R1. This is used for unsigned number. Similarly, we have for signed number. Signed number, we use STRSB and STRSH. The meaning of this one is STRSB is store byte of data, byte of data from the location R0 to the memory location pointed by R1, and it will store 16 bit of data from the location, from the register R0 to the location pointed by R1. But this is used for signed numbers. We have two class of numbers, signed and unsigned, because when the numbers are stored in the register, so register directly 32 bit number can be stored either from memory, 32 bit numbers can be stored to the from memory, or 8 bit numbers can be stored to the memory, or 16 bit numbers can be stored. When case of unsigned numbers, it's very easy, but in the case of signed numbers, the MSB of the signed number, based on the MSB of the signed number, the 32 bit content of register is filled. So that is the one important thing you have to remember. So we have seen this instruction now. So we'll go to the other slide here. So here LDR, we don't have here this LDR instruction, there is no question of signed or unsigned, because if the number is, whether it is signed or unsigned, the number is a 32 bit number, whatever the number may be signed or unsigned, the 32 bit numbers comes and stored in the register. So there is no question of signed and unsigned. There is no instruction for LDR instruction, separate LDR instruction for signed and unsigned numbers. So this is about load and store instruction. In the next class, we will see arithmetic and logical instruction. Thank you for your cooperation.